morning. Ron Liddell, Anthony Liddell, Dr. Janet, Kate Copeland, good morning. Waking up, yeah. With John P. Key. Can't forget it. I can't forget it. Get it. Get it. My brothers and sisters, and listen, I am an hour late. Sister Rhonda, I'm an hour late. This hour behind thing messed me up. My alarm went off and I set my alarm an hour late. So yeah, you didn't miss it, but if I was on time, you would have missed it. Amen. And so I'm in New Orleans. Get ready to catch a flight in a couple of hours to come back home. Amen. But hey, it's all good. Thank God. Amen. That God is still good. Hey, Brother Bernard Close. God bless you, man. Janet K. Copeland. Dr. Janet Copeland. My good friend, my classmate for life. Amen. Good to see you this morning as well. And yes, I cannot forget what the Lord has done for me. Amen. I can't forget it. I can't forget it. I won't forget it. Amen. My mind won't even allow me to forget what the Lord has done for me. Amen. And I know I've gotten quite a few texts. I got quite a few texts on my phone. Pastor, what happened? Where you all right? This is the first time. Amen. I have been an hour late. I have done this. I have done Morning Glory for over a year and a half. Amen. And this is the first time that I've been an hour late. Lord, have mercy. Amen. But nevertheless, we're here. Hey, Sister Celeste, God bless you, ma'am. I'm an hour late, Celeste, and you pray for your pastor, all right? But amen. Thank God for another day. Thank God that He has blessed us. Thank God He has kept us with His redeeming blood. Brother Jerry Hinton, good morning to you, man. Always glad to see you. Amen. Amen. We are, for as I'm concerned, Jerry, we covenant brothers. We belong, amen, to the same church, the same pastor, amen, Dr. Anthony Copeland in Suffolk, Virginia. And we give God praise for that. Amen. God is good to us, and we're going to give Him praise anyhow and anyway. Amen. God is good. Hallelujah. I'm praying that you're having a good morning so far. I pray that your attitude is right. Amen. And I hope and pray, amen, that you will have a good day in Jesus' name. Amen. I've been in church pretty much all this week, ever since Sunday. Amen. I've been in church all this week. Amen. I've heard some good preaching. Amen. I've heard some good preaching. And at the same time, I am concerned that with all this preaching we're doing, amen, we're not being relevant about what's going on in our world. Amen. I am concerned that we're not talking about, amen, what is going on in our world and in this country. And so that concerns me. Amen. I know, we all don't preach the same thing. Amen. We all don't preach the same thing. Amen. I know that, more people are concerned about having church. Having church. Amen. And that is dancing and shouting and speaking in tongues. And all that's fine and dandy. Amen. But still, the people need to know what is going on. The people need to know, amen, that our freedoms in this country are being threatened. Amen. People need to know, amen, that, amen, the devil is out to kill, steal, and destroy. Amen. The people need to know, amen, that this country, our democracy is at stake. Amen. Our democracy is at stake. And in just a few months from now, amen, we could be a totally different country. Amen. In just a few months. In just a few months. And I'm troubled by that. But yet we're shouting, we're dancing, we're speaking in tongues as if, amen, nothing is going on. That bothers me. And that bothers me because, looking at documentaries, look, I was born in 1967. But looking at documentaries, amen, from the early 60s, the mid 60s, even in the late 50s, if you will, the black church, amen, was engaged in letting people know and informing people what was going on in this country. The black church was on the front line, amen, of keeping the members informed of what was going on about the injustices that's going on in this country. Amen. And I believe that the black church need to go back to that. We are so concerned that we don't want to offend nobody. Amen. That's the truth. Black churches are so concerned, and of course white churches as well, and of course churches all over. They are so concerned about the offering. They're so concerned about the budget, meeting the budget, amen, that they don't want to deal with current day issues because they don't want to offend nobody. But let me tell you, my brothers and sisters, listen, I'd rather be voted out of a church. Do you hear what I said? I'd rather be voted out of a church, amen, than to not deal with our current issue. Amen. Good morning, Jackie Banks and Eli Banks. God bless you. I'm serious about that. This country is in trouble. We are on the precipice, amen, of not being a democracy. Amen. And nobody's talking. It's almost like the song that we used to sing back in the day. I can't hear nobody pray. I can't hear nobody pray. Way down yonder by myself. And I can't hear nobody pray. Amen. I can't hear nobody talking about our current issues. Amen. I can't hear nobody, amen, being prophetic, if you will, standing up, being a priest and prophet of this day. We want something to feel good. We want a feel good service. Amen. But we don't want to deal with the current issues that is going on in this country. Amen. And that bothers me, amen, to a serious degree. But anyway, nevertheless, amen, we do know that God is still on the throne. We do know that God is still in charge. But here is the thing, my brothers and sisters. God is not going to do for us what we can do for ourselves. Amen. God is not going to do for us what he has empowered us to do for ourselves. Amen. If we know how to read, God is not going to read for us. Amen. If we have a voice to talk, God is not going to talk for us. If we have legs to walk, God is not going to take us down the street when he's given us and empowered us to use our own feet. Amen. If God has given us a voice to stand, amen, and speak truth, God is not going to do that for us when he has empowered us to talk. He has empowered us to walk. He has empowered us to see. He has empowered us to say. He has empowered us, amen, to be the voice for the voiceless. Amen. And God knows I'm concerned. But yet, we want to lay hands on everybody. Yet, we want to tell folk that we're going to be debt free. Amen. Yet we want to tell people that, you know, your bill's going to be paid, and yet we'll not address how, you know, a bunch of old white men, amen, want to take this country back. And that's just being honest. A bunch of old white men want to take this country back. Amen. And claim to make America great again. And my question is, when has America truly been great? Amen. Folk came from Great Britain, stole the land from Native Americans. Right. Was America great then? I think not. Amen. Then they went, amen, to Africa. Amen. And, amen, and stole people from the motherland, brought them to North America, amen, to be slaves. Was America great then? When Jim Crow, amen, was the law of the land, was America great then? I think not. Hallelujah. Lord have mercy. All the wars that America was engaged in, and many black and brown people, amen, died of senseless wars in the name of democracy. Was America great then? I don't think so. When has America ever been great? When has America, amen, repented of their sins? Hallelujah. They haven't. Amen. Lord have mercy. And so, I'm concerned. But if I am one of the lone voices crying in the wilderness, amen, preparing the way of the Lord and standing for justice, then I'll do that. Even if they have to be on the streets, amen, I'll do that. Amen. It bothers me, amen, that this pastor, amen, teaches the book of Revelation, amen, and, you know, folk won't even participate. Don't even want to know what's going to happen in the last days. It bothers me. Amen. It bothers me that people don't want to know, that people want to shut their ears, you know, and just continue to go all about their merry way. knowing that at some point and someday they won't be merry anymore. They won't be happy anymore. Lord have mercy. Amen. You know what? You know what they did? When they came from England to supposedly be free, you know what they offered the natives? They gave them alcohol. They gave them alcohol. That's what they did. They gave them alcohol. And guess what? And the natives to this day have been cursed with alcoholism. You go to these settlements, you go to, amen, where natives live. That's right, and sugar. That's right. Because you know alcohol is made from sugar anyway, right? You go, amen, to these places where natives live, and they're and I'm gonna tell you, well over 50% of native settlements in Arizona, New Mexico, amen, all of those places, amen, at least 50% are alcoholics, amen. Go to Alaska, where there's a lot of natives, amen. Guess what? You go to Alaska, because I've been there for 3 years. Soon as you come from the airport, there's this main road called Airport Way, and you see more bars and more liquor lounges and liquor stores on that main road. Amen. Those folk have been cursed with alcoholism. Amen. Lord have mercy. That's right. You go on these reservations, they're filled with alcohol. Amen. Fathers, mothers, children are alcoholics. And it all started, amen, when the European came to America, amen, came to this land, amen, and gave the natives sugar and alcohol. And because they were so inebriated, the natives, amen, they gave up their land. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. That's a fact, my brothers and sisters. Lord have mercy. But thanks be unto God that God is still on the throne. And God is a God of justice. Amen. Amen. And we need to teach these things in our pulpits. Amen. Amen. We need to do this because some people don't know the history of this country. And some people even believe, even black folk believe, that this country was founded on Christian principle. The devil is a liar. I said the devil is a liar. This country was not found on Christian principles. Amen. This country was founded, amen, by shedding blood, innocent blood, Lord have mercy, and taking things that did not belong to them. Amen, somebody. Amen. Lord have mercy. And so, maybe if I'm on a rant, then I'm on a rant. It's all good. Amen. But we need to tell the truth. And in our pulpits, we won't preach about it. Amen. And even with, let me tell you, even with some organizations that I'm involved in, I'm going to challenge them. What are we doing about Project 2025? Amen. I'm not going to waste Little Union Baptist Church funds if the organizations that we are involved with are not addressing, amen, the issues of our day. If they're not going to address the threat in this country, then you know what? We're just going to pull away and pull out. That's it. That's it. I'm not going to continue to get along just to get along. I'm not going to do that. If we don't stand for something, we will fall for anything. Amen. Amen. Folk will shout over the fact that a preacher tell them, amen, that God is going to get them out of debt. They'll shout over that. amen, but won't shout over the truth that we need to get out and vote. He won't shout over that. Amen. Some people call it politics. Well, Pastor, you know, that's politics. And the church ought not to be involved in politics. The devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. I'm going to say that again. The devil is a liar. We need to know. The churches, folk need to know what's going on, because some folk don't watch the news. Some folk don't read. Amen. Some people can't afford cable. You know, you can't even get your local channels now if you don't pay for watching it. Amen. A few years ago, amen, we could get at least our local channels for free. You can't even get your local channels for free now. You got to pay somebody to even watch television in your local area. Am I right about it? Amen. Amen. Lord have mercy. God bless you, Sister Dolores Howard. Amen. I try to be honest as I can. God bless you. Amen, Deborah Fuller. Deborah Fuller, you would have missed it if I got up on time, but I set my clock wrong. Amen. I set it for Louisiana time, Central Standard Time, and so I end up getting up an hour later. Lord have mercy. Deborah says, preach, because Lord knows that's the truth. America was not founded on Christian principles. Greed and hatred. Really? Really? That's the absolute truth. I was an ICWA social worker and needed to remove children because, amen, of DV. Lord have mercy. Amen. Amen. And Lord help us today. Lord help us today. You know, you can go to the liquor store and drink all you want, right? Nobody will stop you from doing that. Amen. But guess what? They want to stop you from paying a reasonable price for medication. They want to stop you, amen, from being able to buy insulin for $35. The Dr. Raphael Warnock, amen, who was the lead, amen, in passing that law. Amen. Project 2025 want to change the trajectory of this country. They want to raise, you know, prices again for the pharmaceutical companies so they can continue to get rich. Amen. All of these pharmaceutical companies, the pharmaceutical companies are so rich that their commercials are almost really an infomercial, right? It's an infomercial. Some of these commercials are a minute to a minute and a half long. Why? They got it in their budget. It's not hurting them. Amen. To buy time during Super Bowl. Amen. It don't hurt Nike to pay well over a few million dollars for a minute spot in a Super Bowl commercial. Amen. Lord have mercy. We're living in the last days. We're living in the last days. And my brothers and sisters, nobody wants to be inconvenienced anymore. Amen. I got a problem with the NAACP. NAACP now. Amen. All they want to do is give awards to celebrities. Amen. I know they're doing some work behind the scenes. Amen. I know they have the defense fund. Amen. And they represent and fighting in court. But you know what? You don't hear about that. All you hear about is the image awards. Amen. Giving awards to celebrities. And some of these celebrities, amen, the stuff that they're producing and the stuff that they're showing on BET is just horrific. Amen. The BET awards. I don't even watch any award shows anymore, because it glorifies black folk in a negative light. Lord have mercy. And so I don't want to watch award shows. I don't do it anymore. Amen. I don't watch that mess anymore. I'm not watching these young black girls on these award shows twerking, selling sex, exposing their bodies. Amen. I don't watch that mess. Amen. But yet, you know, we have pastors and priests all over the country watching this stuff and commenting on Facebook. I'm not watching that mess no more. Amen. I'm not doing that. Not doing it. I'm not supporting that mess. I don't care if you're black. I don't care if you're white. Amen. If you're denigrating, amen, black culture, amen, I'm done with that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to support it. Amen. And so because of charge to keep, I have, and a God I have to glorify. Amen. And so, yeah, I am troubled. I am troubled. I am troubled. I am troubled. Amen. We're shouting in our churches. We're dancing in our churches. You're speaking in all these tongues. We supposedly prophesying to people. Amen. But don't want to deal with what's going on in our country. We don't want to talk about the injustices that are happening. We don't want to say that black lives matter. And when we say black lives matter, we're not just talking about just black people, but people of color matter. Amen. Amen. We have contributed to this country. Our foreparents, people of color, built the White House, built the nation's capital with slave labor. Lord have mercy. Hallelujah. Folk don't want to talk about that. They don't want to talk about how one of the other things that Project 2025 want to do, amen, is to get rid of African American studies, Latino studies, anything that is not about whiteness. They want to get it out of the public schools and get it out our public colleges. Amen. Amen. African American studies, Latino studies, they want it out of the colleges, state colleges. They can't do much about, amen, private colleges. But then again, they're going to do something with it when it comes to private college, because guess what? You won't get federal money. You won't get federal dollars unless you do what we say. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. Amen. Amen. And amen. Listen, let me share this devotional with you. Amen. So you can go about your day. Amen. And hopefully folk will hear this. Amen. Later on. Yes. Red, yellow, black, and white. We are precious in his sight. That's right, Sister Ronald Dale. Amen. Amen. Listen, I'm not anti-white. I'm not at all. I got many white friends. Amen. Many white friends. I'm not anti-white. Listen, there were white people in the military that helped me to get where I am today. There are white people that have helped me along the way, and I'm grateful for them. So I don't dislike white people. Absolutely. I love white people. I love everybody. Amen. But we do know that there's half the people in this country who are white, who don't like us and want to keep us in our place. Amen. And it's unfortunate we got black people who hate the fact that they're black. We've got red people who hate the fact that they're red. We have Asians who hate the fact that they're Asian. Amen. We got Latinos, we got natives who hate the fact that they are, and they want to be white. Amen. 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 Lord have mercy. But I'm proud of who I am. You ought to be proud of who you are. If you're white, you ought to be proud that you're white. If you're black, you ought to be proud that you're black. If you're red, you ought to be proud that you're red. If you're yellow, you ought to be proud that you're yellow. Amen. God created all of us in his image and in his likeness. Amen. We ought to be proud of who we are. But what you're not going to do is tell me that your race is greater than mine. That's what you're not going to do. You're not going to convince me of that. You're not going to convince me that you were made smarter than me. You're not going to convince me that God made a race greater than another. You're not going to convince me of that. Because I serve a God, amen, a God of justice, of God who made us equal. Hallelujah. I believe that with my whole heart. I believe his word. Amen. And if God is a God of whiteness, then guess what? The whole Bible, we can throw it in the trash. Amen. We can throw it in the trash. But we can't throw it in the trash because he's not a white God. He's not a black God. He's not a red God. He's not a red state God. He's not a blue state God. God is neither Republican nor Democrat. God is not even independent. Amen. God is God all by himself. Hallelujah. And God stands for what is right. Amen. Amen. And amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Let me share this devotional with you. Amen. Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 6 and 7 says this. These commandments that I give you today are to be upon your heart. Impress them to your children. Talk about them when you sit at home and when you walk along the road, when you lie down and when you get up. And this is really what I've been saying, my brothers and sisters. Amen. This is what I've been crying out about. My teachings. Amen. I have said it over and over again. Mothers, fathers, tell this to your children. Tell this to your grandchildren. Sit down with them when you have a meal and let them know, amen, what's going on in this world and how they need to get involved. And they need, amen, you need to light a fire even under them. Amen. You can agree to disagree, but still, you got to tell your children and your grandchildren what is going on in our world. And this is exactly what Deuteronomy is telling us. Deuteronomy 6, 6 and 7 says this. These commandments that I give you today are to be upon your heart. In other words, you ought to be concerned. Impress them on your children. Tell your children. Talk about them when you sit at home and when you walk along the road, when you lie down, and when you get up. Amen. Actually, these things ought to be discussed with the spouses, right? When y'all laying down in bed, get ready to go to bed, or when you wake up together. You ought to talk about the affairs of this world and what can you do to make this world better. Amen. That's what Deuteronomy is saying. And so, listen, check this out. Now I lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. And if I should die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to take. Who remember that prayer? Amen. This is a prayer that great-grandmother taught my grandmother when she was a child. Years later, my grandmother taught it to my mother. My mother taught it to me. And I taught it to my children. It continues through generations as a means of teaching our children the principles of prayer and the power of God. Amen. That prayer is so embedded within me that even now, hallelujah, it sometimes comes to mind and I realize I've been reciting it, amen, subconsciously. Amen. Psalm 31 and 5 says, into your hands I commit my spirit. Redeem me, O Lord, the God of truth. Amen. This scripture was routinely memorized by Jewish people. Amen. God bless you and good morning to you, Brother Linwood Turner. God bless you, sir. Amen. And belated happy birthday, amen, to you. Amen. Hallelujah. But this particular psalm was a scripture routinely memorized by Jewish people. It was also, it has also been identified as a prayer that was commonly taught to children who would recite it at night, just as some of us recite it, "Now I lay me down to sleep." Amen. Those weren't then merely words, amen, that Jesus thought appropriate as he prepared to die. Because remember, when Jesus was on the cross, hey, Sister Andy, God bless you, amen. Look, when Jesus was on the cross, did he not say, "Lord, unto thy hands I commit my spirit"? Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Those were just not mere words that Jesus thought appropriate as he prepared to die. They were familiar words that came to him as he faced the most difficult moments of his life, at the moment he needed it the most. As parents, my brothers and sisters, we need to teach our children those things that they will remember, those things that will stay with them throughout their lives and come to their remembrance when they need them. Amen. And so even if your children don't want to hear it, tell them anyway. When you're sitting down at the table having a meal with your children, my brothers and sisters, talk to them about the current events, what's going on in our country. See if they know what's going on. And if they know, if they don't know, educate them. Amen. Educate them. Because the country that we know now, if we're not careful, we will soon know no more. Amen. And so we got to be concerned enough to share with our children, to share with our grandchildren, what's going on in this country. Amen. Amen. Will you, amen, be dedicated in sharing with your children and grandchildren? Amen. Because some of our children are living carefree lives. Amen. Yes, they haven't experienced the racism that many of us experience. Am I right? They haven't experienced injustices that many of you experience. Many of you, amen, grew up in the 50s and the 60s. And your children and grandchildren never experienced, amen, that they had to go to the back of the bus. They never experienced where they saw a water fountain where it said whites only. A restaurant that says whites only. They never experienced, amen, a Woolworth, amen, or a cafe wherein they could not be served. And we got to share the history with them. Amen. Got to share it. Hallelujah. If you don't share it, my brothers and sisters, you failed your children. You failed your grandchildren if you don't share your experience. Because there are people in this country who wants to take us back. Amen. And so, again, Deuteronomy 6:6 and verse 7 tells us, "These commandments that I give you today are to be upon your heart. Impress them on your children. Talk about them when you sit at home and when you walk along the road, when you lie down and when you get up." And that's one of the things I commend, amen, our Jewish brothers and sisters. I commend them because you know what? They are good with passing along their history with their children. Every child that's in the Jewish family, even until this day, they know about Moses. They know about how God delivered them from Egyptian rule. They know about how they crossed over the Red Sea. They know about how they crossed over the Jordan and went into that land that flowed with milk and honey. They know about the Holocaust. Amen. They know about it. Amen. And they will stand and fight for until this day. And you know what? Nobody tells the Jewish folk, get over it. Nobody tells the Jewish folk, that was years ago, the Holocaust. Get over it. They will not get over it. Amen. And they should not get over it. And guess what? We ought not to get over how our ancestors suffered, was brought to this country, built this country on slave labor. Amen. And because, again, that experience still affects, amen, people of color today. As I said, the experience when white folks came to this land and gave the natives alcohol and sugar, amen, it affects natives today. Amen, somebody. Amen, somebody. It affects them even to this day. And so what did America do? The government tried to appease the natives by giving them certain pieces of land, put them on reservations. Amen. Which are really, if you will, concentration camps. That's all they are. Y'all can have casinos. Amen. You can get rich off of casinos. Lord have mercy. And it's okay for a lot of natives that they got their little section and yet they're dying. Amen. Because of lack of knowledge. And they're dying because of alcoholism. Lord have mercy. Let's pray, my brothers and sisters. God, you have put us in families so that we might share our knowledge of you from generation to generation. But not only sharing our knowledge of you, hallelujah, but to share what our ethnicity went through and the struggles and the strain that they went through in order for us to have a decent life in this day and in this age. Let us be faithful to impress your word and the truth of the struggle upon our children. Let us talk of you in our homes as we walk along, as we lie down, and when we get up. But not just talk of you, Lord, but talk about the struggles that we went through, the strain that our foreparents went through, amen, the injustices that they went through. Let your word ever be on our lips. Let justice ever be in our minds and in our hearts so that our children will learn of your faithfulness. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, and amen. Hallelujah. 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 Sister Ronald Dale says, it affects us Indians and you hear nothing about it. Absolutely. Amen. Good morning, Sister Van Tinsley. Just got me. I got you. I was late. I was a whole hour late, Sister Van. That's not on you. That's on me. Amen. Sister Ronald Dale said, because they don't want, amen, to rely on the government. And I understand. They don't want to rely on the government because guess what? You can't really trust the government, can you? You can't trust the government. Amen. You can't. And so we trust in God. I know he cares for me on mountaintops and on the stormy sea. Though billows roll, he comforts my soul. My heavenly Father watches over me. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. 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 Thank God for his word, right? Thank God that he is so good to us. Thank God that he is faithful to us. Amen. God is so kind. Hallelujah. Y'all hear this song in the background? Jesus can work it out. Jesus can work it out. The problem that I had. I stopped worrying about it. He can work it out if you let him. That pain that would not move took it to the upper room. The burden that I bore. Thank you, Sister Lois. Yes, it's important to stay hydrated in Louisiana. God knows you're right. That's why they have bingo. Lord have mercy. Yeah, can't trust the government. Thank you, Sister Deborah, for the safe travel wishes. Thank you. Getting on the plane today. Habit that you had just couldn't seem to break. And God is teaching us, Sister Rhonda, to be self-sufficient. Absolutely. Not to depend on the government. Amen. That's right, Brother Linwood. He can work it out. Gave it over to Jesus. Yeah, my troubles, my cares, I turned it over to Jesus. Gave it over to the Lord. He worked it out. Jesus can work it out. If you let him. Thank you, Sister Van. And can I say this? Listen, what's so sad about in New Orleans, with all these restaurants in New Orleans? Guess what? Nobody served greens. Couldn't get no vegetables to save your life. Everything is fried. Everything is fried. Amen. Just yesterday was the first time, and I've been there almost a week. Yesterday was the first time Reverend Beard took me to a restaurant. We had to go almost 15, 20 miles out of the city just to get some cabbage. And guess what? When we got there, guess what? They gave us the last serving of cabbage. Amen. So they're serving food, right? All these restaurants serving food that's killing black people, killing people of color. Amen. All this fried food. No vegetables whatsoever. Lord, help us today. But I'm a witness. He'll see you through. Isaac was the only one led him to a mountain high. Over there, you'll see a lamb. Didn't he work it out? Didn't he work it out? Job was sick so long, flesh fell from his bone. Wife, cattle, and children, everything he had was gone. Wife came running to him, devil all in her eyes. Job been sick so long, curse your God and die. Job looked at the woman. Woman, you sound foolish. You don't sound like my wife. I don't have no doubt. Lord's gonna work it out. Lord's gonna work it out. Hallelujah. Shout on, Van. Shout on. Didn't he work it out? My, my, my. Gave it over to the Lord. He worked it out. Oh, yeah. Pharaoh, Pharaoh, let my people go. Let my people go. Thank you, Janet. God bless you, darling. He didn't believe in God. Pharaoh's heart got hard. Didn't believe in God. No, no, let I'm not going to let your people go. That's what Pharaoh said. I ain't gonna let him go. He will work it out. Won't he do it? Can he do it? Yeah, rudder roll up on both sides. The soldiers drowned, Pharaoh drowned. Didn't he work it out? Didn't he work it out? Yeah. Didn't he work it out? How you gonna pay your rent? All your money spent. Know you need to buy some food. Baby needs some pair of shoes. Yeah, baby need pair of shoes. Got a light bill too? Got a gas bill too. Yeah, telephone. Telephone disconnect. Wait for your next paycheck. Tell you what you ought to do. Let me tell you what you ought to do. Tell you what you ought to do. Jesus will see you through. Yes, he will. That's right, Deborah. Pharaoh didn't know. My. Yes, he can. He can work it out. He gonna work it out in the United States too. Amen. If we cry loud and spell out, amen, God's gonna work it out. If we do our part, God's gonna do his part. Amen. Hallelujah. My soul done got happy, y'all. Because Jesus can work it out. Amen. God bless you. God keep you. I love you. We'll see you tomorrow. Amen. For Hallelujah Anyhow Friday at 7. Amen. At 7 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. God bless you. God keep you. We'll see you tomorrow. In Jesus' name. Amen.